Yeah, I mean, I think anytime you win close games and high intensity games, it helps you. You know, I think we're confident coming from behind. We're confident from playing, you know, from ahead. And I think, you know, having to play in an elimination game that you have to win if you want to move on and win the game, I think can definitely give you some momentum. You know, there is a week off in between, so I think the big thing that we have to do out here is just continue to execute at a high level, play loose, and you know, play green. If we do that, I think good things will happen. Yeah, it's a really nice park. You know, we're super excited to be able to practice on the field. We were over at another facility before, a turf facility, which was really nice, to Hippie P. So we just got some ground balls, took some fly balls, just sort of kind of get familiar with the surroundings there. There's a lot of foul territory like most pro parks have. It's a really big field like most pro parks are. It does have a very similar feel to the Appleton Field, and I think that's probably why they chose it. It's a really nice field, so I think the guys are excited to be here, and hopefully we can go out and play Beacons baseball. Yeah, we've already seen the starter for Webster, so we know what he does well. He's very good, so I don't know if seeing him or not really is a big advantage, but at least we know what he throws, and we have some trends on how he likes to attack the hitters. But the bottom line is you got to get off good swings and barrel up some baseballs. You know, we hit him hard early in Florida and then let him settle in, and he retired us pretty easily after that. So I think if we can keep the approach we had early in the game against him, hopefully we can have some success tomorrow. Yeah, I mean, I think our starting pitching depth is really, really good. And I think looking at least at the other eight teams sort of briefly, a lot of teams have two good starters, a few have three. I feel like we have four or five. So we just got to get there. And I think you got to treat every day like it's an elimination game, and win that game and survive in advance, and then take the next game as it comes. You know, and I think with the pod format, I like it much better than the eight-team bracket, because if you lose one game in the eight-team, you're pretty much dead. So here, no matter what happens game one, you're still alive because it's double elimination. And, you know, you can kind of start storming back through if you need to. But our goal is to come out and win game one, and whether, you know, find any way that we can do it against Webster, who's, you know, playing really good baseball. They just beat Concordia of Chicago, who was maybe the best team in the country this year. So we know we're going to be up for a challenge tomorrow, and hopefully we can go out there and play really good baseball. Yeah, I think each time you come, there's always going to be, you want the experience, you want the, you know, you want the guys to really take it all in. You just don't want it to get too big. And I feel like, you know, our last trip out in 2017, we were in three really competitive games. So I think we're coming out here with the goal of winning the tournament and being national champs. And I think it's got to just be a, you know, game by game sort of approach, and inning by inning, and just play good, solid baseball. And if we continue to field the ball at a high level and throw a lot of strikes and get those timely hits, no matter who it is in the lineup, you know, I think good things will happen. And we've got a really veteran team. We've played a lot of postseason baseball the last 4 years. A lot of these guys, this has become sort of the new norm, is going deep into the postseason. Hopefully we can go out here and just do what we do well, and not let the stage be too big for us.